problems with Blake's microphone, but let us get you caught up on what Blake found out today. He shared it with us. Today was a big win for 70 employees and their spouses. The jury finding Jacobs Engineering did three things. Mm-hmm. They failed to meet the terms of their contract with TVA or the requirements of the Kingston Site Safety and Health Plan.
That's right. The jury also finding that Jacobs Engineering failed to exercise reasonable care it owed to the plaintiffs. Lastly, and most specifically, it says their breach of duty was capable of causing the following injuries or illnesses.
Yeah, they were talking about hypertension, coronary artery disease, lung cancer, leukemia, skin cancer, allergic contact dermatitis, peripheral neuropathy, asthma, chronic obstruction or obstructive pulmonary disease. That's a long list, but there are even more respiratory diseases. Legal expert Greg Isaac says their team will argue the opposite.
But they're going to say maybe there was other causes. Maybe you smoked. You had bad genes. So it's really going to be interesting to see how they approach this. But if the jury gets mad after hearing case after case, illness after illness, that may lend itself to a significant punitive damages award.
Now, phase two of this process will basically be a series of mini trials, we're being told. The jury will hear about specific injuries, possible causes, and determine if they deserve to be compensated.
Punitive damages are designed to punish. When conduct reaches a certain level outside the legal norm, that's when punitive damages would be warranted.
All right, the court documents say those 70 workers and their spouses were exposed to more than 5 million cubic yards of coal fly ash sludge. We reached out to the more than 15 attorneys representing the people in this lawsuit, and we want to let you know Tyler Roper, one of the attorneys in the case, saying, quote, "I'm just glad to see the legal system actually works, that the worker's story can be told, and the jury determined the truth. Our clients and our country deserve it," end quote.
Now, one of the other plaintiff's attorneys on the case got back to us calling it a tremendous day for their clients and that he appreciates the jury's hard work. And of course, we'll stay on top of this and let you know what happens next. The plaintiffs also claiming, by the way, that Jacobs Engineering did not monitor random workers for coal ash exposure during that cleanup.
Yeah, and it even alleges they manipulated the monitoring results of coal fly ash exposure. Again, in the court paperwork, Jacobs has denied wrongdoing. We reached out to the company today. So far, we have not heard back. As you mentioned, we will keep following phase two of this case.